All right, so ever since with the video, we've took about a 10-minute break and slowly sipping on this great, lovely fucking IPA from Rough Tail and Central Standard Collaboration. Happy Hella Haze. I loved it. Both me and Brad gave it 10s. Brad's over in the corner right now masturbating. You can hear him kind of smacking. He's like, he loved it too. He's kind of kicking himself in the ass, but he sent his wife to Rough Tail from Edmond to go pick up another 4-pack of this.
He makes it sound like a long ways, but it's literally like a 20-minute drive.
He got 2 4-packs of the other, the Central Standard version. No, I'm sorry, the American Solera version. Blaze Brothers, we didn't like it nearly as much. Hell, not close to nearly as much, honestly.
Honestly, I gave the Blaze Brothers a 9.5. But if I would have had the Hella Haze first,
you gave it like an 8.5.
Yeah,
like I gave it.
Yeah.
There's, I mean, it's no, I'm not saying it's shit, but it's.
If you don't want that, I'll drink it.
Anyway,
I'm just fucking with you, dude.
I got one to myself at the house.
I've got.
Yeah, but I didn't pay for it. All right, so now we're coming up on an older Rough Tail Crowler, 11/02/17. So this is what day is this?
12/7.
Yeah, so this is a month and 5 days old. Sweet Tart, keep cold, and it's been cold ever since. It just hadn't been opened. It's a little older beer. Brad's gonna tell you what it is.
Sweet Tart features boysenberry exclusively. Commonly described as a mix between juicy blackberries and sweet raspberries, the boysenberry's tartness complements the Berliner Weisse sour style perfectly. I haven't tried this one. I done the that's a big ass head.
Some of you might say that's not a fucking beer. Yeah, it sure is. You alright?
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing?
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing?
I had the Hella Haze in my mouth.
Oh.
Or Hella Haze or Dog Balls or.
The last anything I had with boysenberry in it was the
E-juice, huh?
Yeah.
When they done boysenberries, blackberries, and
blueberries.
Blueberries.
Yeah, it was the E-juice. The smell goes through with it. I had the Iron Monk Bright D Weizenstauer as well.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I forgot about that
smell one. Smell goes through with it.
Man. I carried my vape in the house.
I got a lot of head. What do you smell?
I mean, it's kind of like it smells like a real, like, bitter. Like, it smells like a bitter blueberry, blackberry?
Yeah. I was saying blackberry.
Hmm.
It is tart.
Yeah.
But not sour. There is a difference. Tart, more dry, kind of a wine-esque kind of a flavor.
Let's try that again.
I like it. It's probably a lower percentage. I'd say nearing 5.
I don't know that they ever said.
It's a Berliner, so yeah, it's probably lower.
Yeah, they never said.
Check Untappd.
It's fucking good, though.
I will say, it's being a month old, it kind of has the inner tube tire kind of a flavor to it.
Maybe
it's like a dry sweet cranberry with inner tube.
Maybe a little bit in the aftertaste, but fucking Untappd is so goddamn, it's a dick about fucking searching.
Of course, this is, you know, extremely old, so that might be part of the problem. I haven't had this at all until now.
Yeah, I haven't either. I went the day that they released this one and Mixed Signals, which is the one that I reviewed by myself.
Yeah. When he had the Mixed Signals, the day of Twisted Spike's anniversary party, we stopped by Rough Tail, got the E-Juice. He got a pour of the Mixed Signals. I took a drink. He chugged it. And then we left. That was the first time I had the Mixed Signals.
So. Okay, so Sweet Tart is 4.3%.
Oh.
Okay. 5 IBUs.
Yeah, it's super low.
It's got a 4.06 out of 5 on Untappd.
Okay.
I mean,
I'm not a huge fan of it now. I mean, if I was to get a six pack of this and, you know, be running the price of $12 or so, I wouldn't bitch. I think it's still pretty good. It just,
I don't know. I mean,
not as sweet as I want it to be.
Yeah, it's not as sweet and maybe not quite as tart or, you know, sour as I would kind of expect it to be. But I mean, it's it still has a good flavor.
At least, I mean, you know, I'm this far into it and the inner tube flavor is gone.
So yeah, I mean,
that's good.
I didn't get a whole, I mean, I don't know that I'd say inner tube. Like, it's kind of got like a plasticky kind of taste, but
it's a lot better than something like Iron Taste or Metallic or.
Yeah, that's one thing that I really can't do. Like, I mean, you can give me a little bit of like a plasticky, maybe from like some hoses or something in the brewing process kind of taste. But if it's like, tastes like you goddamn aged it in a barrel full of pennies, I'm not gonna fucking drink that. I can't do metallic-y tasting beer. It's just absolutely fucking horrible.
Or even like an IPA that's 6 months old and tastes like nothing but malt and sweetness. I can't stand that either. So, I mean, we have a lot to drink here, but we're gonna go ahead and cut this pretty short. Nice berry. The berry is really good. Honestly, I like it. The initial inner tube taste, it's gone away. It's kind of tart, not excessive, not towards a sour. It's got a good little grain, very, very mild grain, very mild bitterness. Yeah.
The bitterness is almost like
non-existent damn near.
Yeah.
So, almost spin.
All right.
I'm going to say 8.
That's what I gave. It's an 8. Like, I mean, I could fucking drink this. Like, the way it is, I mean, I bet it was better fresh.
Yeah.
I mean,
that's kind of his fuck up.
It is. I should have, you know, even if I'd done it by myself, I should have reviewed this a while back. But I could fucking, I mean, if this was in a six pack, the way it tastes now, for $11 or $12, I would crush a six pack.
Oh, yeah. This would be fresh. This would be a good summer beer. Go into your small town liquor store. If you see it in a six pack, don't buy it. It's probably excessively old. I'm just saying, excessively old. If you were to see this in six pack in your, you know, town of 20,000 people.
That's a small town?
Yeah.
Now you know why I always fucking bitched about only being able to get fucking Coops F5. I lived in a town of less than 3,000 people.
God, I bet that tastes like malty dick, didn't it?
Oh, no.
Oh, really?
I never had a bad one.
Okay.
I bought so much of it, they had to keep it fresh.
Shit.
They bought one case at a time.
So, it's good. It's just more of a summer beer, and as you can tell, it's cold.
A lot of people say that, you know, like stouts are more summer beers and sours are more, or stouts are winter beers. Sours,
I don't care either way.
I don't either. Like, I mean, if it's a good fucking beer, I don't care how fucking cold it is outside. My house is climate controlled. I'm going to sit here and drink this fucking beer. And to me, I would prefer to drink a beer like this over a stout. That's just me. But this one, it needs to be a little more sour, maybe a little sweeter for what it is, but
all right, so go. We'll be seeing you.